Today, Rutgers Athletic Director Tim Pernetti offered me his resignation, and I have accepted it. Tim and I mutually agreed that this is in the best interest of Rutgers. I appreciate the positive things that Tim has done for the university, but I also recognize the gravity of recent developments in regard to the men's basketball program. Now, let me begin by saying that this was a failure of process. I regret that I did not ask to see the video when Tim first told me of its existence, because I am certain that this situation would have had a very different outcome had I done so. So I want to personally apologize to the entire Rutgers community, our faculty, our staff, our students, our parents, our alumni, and the many others who support the great work of this university for the negative impact that this situation has had on Rutgers. I apologize to any student athletes on the team who may have been personally harmed. The kind of chronic and pervasively abusive behavior demonstrated on that video is unacceptable and does not represent the high standards of leadership and accountability we strive for within the Rutgers athletic program. I also apologize to the LGBTQ community and all of us who share their values for the homophobic slurs shown on that video. I personally know how hurtful that language can be. As I indicated in my statement on Wednesday, based on the advice of the university's general counsel and of outside legal advisors, Tim gave me a summary description of the situation regarding Coach Mike Rice last fall. Relying on that summary, I agreed with and supported his recommendation to suspend rather than fire Coach Rice at that time. It was not until Tuesday evening of this week, when I watched the video, that I had the opportunity to witness personally for the first time what Tim had seen last fall. I was deeply disturbed by the behavior the video revealed, which was much more abusive and pervasive than I had understood it to be. As Tim acknowledged Wednesday, his decision to rehabilitate rather than fire Coach Rice was wrong.